are a few bright spots in certain regions, many of the people I caught up with today say most areas are still struggling with low escapement numbers.
The sockeye salmon may be the prized jewel of Bristol Bay when it comes to commercial fisheries, but the highly sought-after king salmon typically runs alongside them during the season. However, data shows king salmon have been well below their escapement goals across the state for the past few years, and this year is no different. Part of the difficulty in this for the Alaska Department of Fish and Game is to tend to each of these individual fisheries. So far, more than 27,000 kings have crossed into the Nooshigak, according to preliminary data from ADF&G, but more than 75,000 crossed by the same time in 2018.
When you have these conflicting goals of harvesting sockeye and trying to manage for king salmon escapement, it gets really complex.
Further north, many on the Yukon are facing a similar story, as enough chum salmon have made their way to allow subsistence fishing near the headwaters. But Fish and Game says king salmon are still well below escapement goals, and many communities further upriver are not able to fish at all.
Our culture really depends on king salmon and chum, and so it really hurts our people. We're not able to fish. We're not able to pass our culture down to the children.
In response to the lack of fish, many in these communities are pivoting to hunting caribou, though their numbers are declining as well, or by shipping food from Fairbanks.
Usually by plane or barge, which is very expensive. The last, it was about 70 cents a pound to send.
Close by, the Kuskokwim region is experiencing something somewhat similar. Sockeye are coming in strong, and ADF&G says it expects to meet escapement goals for king salmon, but their numbers are still well below average. Meanwhile, chum numbers are still on the rise, but there's a ways to go before fishing for them is back on track.
So we expected this year's chum run to be fairly low, and it is fairly low. It's well below average, but it is better than the last few years.
And further down south, near the Alaska Peninsula, the commercial fishery is having a much slower season than usual due to self-imposed restrictions and the market price for salmon.
We took a lot of time off to avoid Western Alaska chums voluntarily, so we had a really poor June fishery.
ADF&G says harvest numbers for sockeye in June totaled just under 900,000, while the average for the past 10 years by the end of last month has been 1.6 million sockeye.
Bristol Bay Area Management Biologist Tim Sands also says the lack of king salmon is most likely due primarily to factors in the ocean, as there is still a king shortage shore-wide. Kuskokwim Area Research Biologist Sean Larson elaborates on that, saying the disappearance could be from a variety of factors, from marine mammals to increased temperatures.